Great customer service can mean the difference between a good experience and a great experience. Everyone seems to have their own stories to tell about that unhelpful store associate or that clumsy waiter, etc., but I think these people have kind of a bad rep. Put yourself in those people's shoes for a second. They're just slightly tired people who have done the same thing repeatedly for like 4 hours, dealing with countless people who are never quite sure what they're looking for. I'd be exasperated. To be honest, hospitality is far too often taken for granted. And so, instead of complaining about them, I'm gonna talk about some times when customer service people absolutely blew me away. Once I was with my mom at a drive-thru, and after we ordered, we drove to the second window to pick up our order. The lady there gave us our food and asked,
"Will you be having any sauce with that?"
I said yes. "Ketchup, please." And she responded with,
"How many packets?"
That was a weird question. No one had ever asked us that before. How about 5?
Oh, okay.
She counted the packets in her hands out loud. And then she gave us 6! Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the pinnacles of customer service right here! She purposefully asked us how many packets of ketchup we wanted so that she could give us more than we asked for. She said,
"Have a nice day!"
with a smile, and as we drove off, I couldn't stop thinking, there are kind people in this world. Another time, I was at the department store looking for a power strip with my mom. There's a pattern here, I should hang out with my mom more. But this wasn't just any power strip. This was one with a switch. A switch so you could turn it on and off remotely. You know those switches? The ones with the that's not important. So we couldn't find it anywhere on the shelf, and as soon as we started scratching our heads, out of nowhere comes an employee.
"Hi, how are you? Finding everything all right today?"
We're trying to find a power strip with an attachable switch, but I mean, it's not just any power strip. It's got, you know, a remote control switch. It goes on, you know, the switch. We can't find it anywhere.
"Well, that's because you're looking in the wrong aisle. Special switches are in aisle 12.
He led us there and swiftly inspected every single shelf. He frowned and said,
"That's weird. They're all normally right here."
I sighed. Just another employee who can't find anything situation. And then he pulled out his walkie-talkie.
"Hey Arnold, do you know more about the locations of special power strips?"
"I'll be right there."
And just like magic, another employee comes out of nowhere. He begins to double check while the first guy tells us,
"You know what, I'm gonna call the guys in the back room."
All the while scanning the computer on his little checker thing. It was amazing. While the average person might look at the scene and be like,
"They have no idea what they're doing."
I was thinking, wow. These people are really devoted to what they do. There is employee networking going on around us and all to help us locate a single insignificant cord. Did I mention it was almost closing time too? In the end, we never found the cord. All those winter shoppers bought the last ones for their Christmas lights. But I left feeling incredibly helped otherwise. These are just two examples, but I'm sure you get my point. When it comes to service, it really is the thought that counts. Actions speak louder than words. Personally, my day gets so much sunnier when I make it through a long, loud, draining line, and on the other side of the line is a person who can stand through the grind with a genuine smile on their face. So let's not take service for granted. Let's give those people a hand, am I right? Right? Huh. Unpopular opinions.
Hey guys, check it out. Yeah.